good, man?
All right, I guess.
I hear you, man.
How you doing?
Doing very well now.
You were parked right next to me.
Ooh.
I had to leave. Got all the people around there.
I thought you left because I was there.
No.
He hates me now.
You know the...
Thank you.
Okay guys, so I thought I'd start this video by apologizing for not talking in between motos. I was with friends and my fiance had come as well, so I didn't want to interrupt too much, to say the least, the friendship and talks that we were having in between motos. So first of all, let's go ahead and review. And as you guys can see, I'm in my office. Pretty cool. You guys can see. You guys can probably guess who my favorite rider is. Got all my replica plates. I got two more Eli Tomac ones coming, and I'm going to be ordering one more also. And I got Ryan Dungy's up there. Right there. That was given to me for free. So moto number one was obviously good. Practice is just practice. You know, you just go out and find lines and figure out what goes on from there. Of course, I felt good in practice. I wasn't pushing, so it's enough about practice. So moto one, it was hard to make passes. The two corners, the one right after the two front singles was flat, and then the right-handed corner was also flat after that. That made it really hard to make passes because that was could have been a big separator, and it usually was. Like, that's where I could make my passes in the past, at least. I like when there were two separate berms there on each of those corners. You can make passes, and the flat turns, really, everybody kind of funneled into one line, or everyone was going down and falling down all over the place and made it hard to make passes. So that was kind of a pain, but Moto 1, I did make passes when people were falling down, and I fought that 125 or 250 in front of me for quite some time. And then he eventually ended up getting away from me on the last lap because I got tired there. So, but moto number one, I got 15th, as you guys saw. So that was a good moto for sure. Moto number two was also pretty good. Actually, that moto was a lot better. There were more line choices. And berms formed because of all the bikes and the quads were going through there. So I could make passes in there, finally, in those two corners. That one left-hander after those two singles, I made two passes there in that one corner. So that it obviously makes a difference if there's two separate lines. And in that corner, with all of them lines going together, I believe there were about four separate lines. And that very outside was the best. Because all those other lines, they funneled into that inside where there were rollers everywhere. And that outside, it was flat almost the entire way through. And no braking bumps before that area either. As long as you cut across a little bit, you missed all the braking bumps, and then you stayed on the gas. Made it easy to pass there. And I felt good that time. I felt a lot more racy. Obviously, being the first race, I was a little bit nervous. So, but now the first race was out of the way, and the second race, or moto, I should say, the second moto, felt way more comfortable, way more confident to start making passes, and I was. People were going down still. But that happens, you know, everybody falls down. But I was making passes, and I felt much better that moto. I feel like I placed higher than 15th, but not, maybe just outside the top 10. There were 21 riders in open D class that day, that night. And I was 15th the first moto. I would say I was about 12th or 13th in the second one. I don't really know. I had to leave earlier than I wanted to so I could check the results. My fiance didn't feel very good, so I packed everything up and we just bounced. In sake for her, so I didn't want to make her wait any longer. So we went home after the motos were finished, so I didn't get a chance to look at the Moto 2 results or overall results. But I'll let you guys know as soon as I find out, hopefully before the next Friday night race. So that's pretty much it, guys. I hope you guys enjoy my little office setup here. I'm going to figure out a camera angle to get everything in here because there's more stuff on this wall you guys can't see. And all these Eli Tomac plates, as soon as I get all the three other ones I need, they're all going to be moved to this one where the Dungy one is. And the Dungy one's going to be moved over here along with four or five other plates I'm going to get. I'll link in the description who I ordered these from. It's a guy on Instagram that I found. Really awesome. Really cool replicas. If you guys ever need any ideas for cool decorations, office decoration, wall decoration, garage, man cave decorations, I'll link them to you guys in the description. So that's pretty much it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys want a different camera angle, please let me know. This is the best camera angle that I could find at this particular time to get at least my plates and this really cool light that my fiance bought me for Father's Day. It says Tentative MX on it. YouTube channel name and MX on it. Really badass. It's blue. It's kind of hard to see because of the camera, but hopefully I'm just using the webcam for my laptop, so I'll get a camera that can get this better. And yeah, so that's pretty much it. It's been Tentative here. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace, guys.